You spent 100 years being miserable, pal. You're overdue for a little serenity.
So, have I been looking any more convincing with the lightsaber? I mean, it's about as much use to me in a fight as a glow-in-the-dark belt buckle. But I figure if I wave it around, maybe it'll scare people off.
If you can't use the lightsaber, you should return it to the Jedi, where it can do some good.
Making me feel like an enormous glowing symbol of virility isn't good? This was the only lightsaber we had, you know, in the whole Enclave. I wasn't in the Jedi Academy proper. Never made it that far. My master ran a recruitment center on Nar Shaddaa. I don't think he had the guts to actually bring me out in public.
I thought all Jedi trained at the Academy.
There's always a few who slip through the cracks. I need you to teach me to fight dirty. You'd think I'd be good at that, you know, but when it gets beyond cowering in doorways, I'm pretty much all point and shoot. Show me how you work your magic.
No offense, but I'd rather see you as non-lethal as possible.
Fine. I think I've learned a lot just from watching you.
Tell me, Captain, how do you choose your path in life? What guides you?
I prefer improvisation. Only a fool gets locked into a single way of thinking.
You're like a starship without navigation, flying blind. I adhere to the Res Sonare, the core of what it means to be Mandalorian, the sacred law giving us direction and purpose.
Education and armor. Self-defense, our tribe, our language, our leader, all help us survive. We must educate our children as Mandalorians, obey the commands of Mandalore, speak Mandoa, and defend our clans.
Did you leave out something? I didn't hear anything about serving the Empire and wiping out the Republic.
Every action a Mandalorian takes is because of the Res Sonare. It tells us why we fight and whom to kill. My travels with you have been worthwhile, Captain. Few Mandalorians experience Republic space as I have. Fewer still see the Jedi up close without having to kill them.
Don't hold back on my account. As long as nobody traces it back to this ship, kill whomever you like.
I have no reason to fight Jedi while in your company. If that changes, I appreciate your gesture of consent. Jedi are the most respected warriors in the galaxy. And yet, they have never truly defeated the Mandalorians. No matter how punishing our defeats by them, we always return. One day the Jedi will bow down before us. There is a method to your madness. When we met, I thought your fighting was driven by impulse, with no strategy or plan. But I began to see a pattern in the chaos.
My style serves me well.
That I have never questioned. I have thought of incorporating some of your tricks into my own repertoire. It would certainly earn me the edge of surprise should I be among Mandalorians again.
You probably think I'm chasing Debrillion's throne to get rich, don't you? Who wouldn't want that high life? Have millions of subjects pay you to run their lives? You can sign me up anytime. Ruling a planet is a big responsibility. One bad decision can hurt a lot of people. I've seen what bad leadership does to a place. Alderaan, Nar Shaddaa, even Coruscant. They all suffer because of who's in power. I'm not looking to plunder Debrillion. I want to make it better, run their society the right way. From everything I've heard about your homeworld, it could use someone decent in charge. Never thought of myself as decent before. Maybe I can sell that. Every successful leader has the same strength. They're perceived as generous by their subjects. Give the people just enough of what they want, and they'll leave you alone. That's something the King of Debrillion doesn't understand. For a second, I thought I was seeing a whole new side of you. False alarm. I'm just saying what everyone else is thinking. Nothing wrong with that. I can make this work. It's all about negotiation, and I'm good at that. I'm just thinking out loud now. We should get back to business. The longer I spend here, the more it feels like home. I'm even starting to appreciate Corso. Must be coming down or something. Promise me you'll visit often when I'm Queen of Debrillion.
Aren't you afraid being friends with a common freighter captain will tarnish your reputation?
First, there's nothing common about you. Second, the whole point of being queen is that I get to do whatever I want. It'd be nice to sneak away with you for the occasional break. Go someplace dangerous. Steal something expensive. Mock the bad guys. When you think about it, being queen of a planet provides the perfect alibi. We should take advantage of that.
I knew your whole only in it for the money thing was just a front.
Thank you, Captain. I couldn't live with myself if we'd left Dan Lazine with that pig.
I lost a lot of money on that deal. I'll be expecting you to make it up to me.
Right. I get it. You've got a reputation to maintain. Governor's office on Ord Mantell says thanks, by the way. With the disarm codes, they finally got real peace there. It's hard to say if something like that is worth a life.
Yeah? What's your distress? Talk to me.
How refreshing. The whole I'm honored to serve you, revered master, does get tiresome. Master Sumali, I've been following your career. I hear you have a special interest in the Void Wolf.
I've got a bad track record with false Jedi.
I told you I was sorry. What do you want, flowers?
Then it's good you're traveling with someone who can vouch for me. Ironic as that may be.
Nice to see you again, Sumali. Just don't expect me to call you Master.
Sounds like there's a story here.
Not one you're going to hear. She is who she says. Let's leave it at that.
We're not born to the robes, Captain. The Force sometimes picks unlikely candidates. Risha, do you remember Shars Kartur?
What did they used to call us? The Triple Threat? Didn't she join the SIS?
One of their top agents. When you took out the White Maw's cloaking abilities on Hoth, it drew the Void Wolf's attention. He went there, and Shars followed.
Alone? Is she crazy?
The Republic sent an entire platoon of troopers to escort her. The Void Wolf's assassins killed them all. She's alive, but trapped on Hoth.
Is there a special guilt power in the Force? Jedi always make me feel like I'm talking to my mom.
The sign of a heavy conscience.
When I got Sharis's distress call, she had taken refuge in one of the Void Wolf's private vaults. Go quickly if you can. I fear you're Sharis's last hope.
Ready for action.
Greetings. You are cleared for the following travel routes.
Much better than I expected.
Bye.
Good to see you.
Hope you're all right.
Close the door. I figured this was the last place the Void Wolf's bloodhounds would go digging, but it won't be long.
Tell me what happened to you.
The Void Wolf's been recruiting. He's courting Huts, the White Maw, hitmen for hire. Anyone who won't pledge loyalty goes to Hard Vacuum. And he's got enough spies in our space station that my cover was blown the minute I landed. What do you think? Is there a way you can smuggle me up without any of his people or our people catching wise?
I signed on for fighting Imperials. You want me to defend you against the Republic, too? That's gonna cost.
I was going to hide in there. It's an automated cargo shuttle full of everything here the Void Wolf thought worth keeping. Go to the space station and get security to let us through, and you're welcome to keep everything in it. I trust you can come up with a story to explain why you're shipping Imperial droids off Hoth.
I'll say one thing, traveling with you is never dull.
Stand by for examination and suggested products. You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Stop it right there. I'm going to need your ID, your papers, and a blasted good reason why you're flying in and out of a war zone for kicks.
How about I add a bit to your salary, just for looking the other way?
Now you're sounding reasonable. It's a tough job working customs. Almost makes you want to ask a special fine of those who don't show the respect. You're clear to go, ma'am. Long live the Republic.
Neatly done. I'll reimburse you the bribe, of course.
Where do we go from here?
I can take it from here. I've got my own ship stashed a few hangars down. Thanks for the help. You're welcome to any of the salvage in the shuttle. Some of it might fetch a good price. And I'll make sure you get anything I learn about the Void Wolf.
Mission accomplished. Sherris is safe.
I admit, I was wondering what to think of Senator Dodonna's pet project. But you saved a life here and aided the war. I can say nothing but thank you.
If there's nothing more, I have places to be.
Of course. Perhaps we'll catch up again sometime, Risha.
Not sure my current occupation will bring me anywhere near the Jedi Temple, but maybe.
I hope this war ends swiftly enough that I will not have cause to call on you again.
Set course for Voss, then, Captain? The permits from Dodonna just came through. Dodonna can wait. I've got a whole galaxy to explore. Don't wait too long. I think the permits have an expiry date. Voss is a little controlling. I took the liberty of looking into the place. Weird planet. Just made contact with the rest of the galaxy after a Sith ship crashed there. Apparently the whole planet's on the leash to some cult of Force users. Empire and Republic are both playing along. This'll be one to wear your best shirt. And remember to say please.